Hi guys, this is John from MoltenZinc.com and this is Game Bird Gourmet. We wanted to do something that was fairly easy, but would allow you to take your game meat out into the field with you. So we made cold cuts. The way we did this is we first ground all of the meat three times. We wanted to break down the structure as much as we could. So we ground it once through a 3/8 plate and then twice through a 3/16 plate. When you're doing this, get the pheasant basically frozen and make sure the chunks are small enough so it fits easily down the throat of your grinder. It will grind really fast, even on that third grind, if that meat is that cold. Then we went ahead and we added our seasoning, which in our case was the feta cheese and spinach bratwurst seasoning. I don't like feta cheese or spinach, but I do love this seasoning. We also added carrot fiber to help it retain some more moisture. And so it could do even more, we added some cold phosphate. Also, we added the SureCure as we normally would. So as we're mixing this, we added a cup of water to begin with, and we just started mixing it with our hands. You want to mix it and mix it and mix it. You can't overmix this. Once you're about almost done, add another half to a quarter cup and continue mixing. At this point, just load it into your stuffer and choose whatever casing you want that's going to have the diameter. We chose the 3-inch plastic casings. They're easy to work with. You just put them in cold water for 15 minutes before you're ready to stuff, take them out, and they work really, really well. Now for thermal processing, we just wanted to keep it nice and simple, so we did it in our oven. We just took a smoke stick from our PK100, laid it on the top rack, ran the loop of our casing over that, and just hung it right there and let everything, all the air, get to all of the meat, and it didn't leave any indentations. As you can see, it's nice and perfectly round. Now, that casing is a head cheese casing, but as you can see, I mean, it makes perfect size cold cuts. Couldn't have asked for anything better than that. Now, for slicing, we wanted to slice it as thin as we could, but it is sometimes difficult to slice restructured cuts like this that small. However, on this, we were able to get it really nice and small. That's the carrot fiber and also maybe a little bit of the cold phosphate, plus all that mixing we did really paid off. Now, we specifically did not add any pork fat to this. You definitely can for taste, but we wanted to see what it'd be like just with the breast, and it is really, really good. Now, the thinner you cut this, the better it does taste. I don't know why that's true, but it is true. Making sandwiches with this is awesome, especially if you use Terrapin Ridge Farms pesto aioli. It is absolutely delicious. Obviously, it's gonna work with the spinach and feta. Some Swiss cheese would be excellent on your sandwich, or if you're having a lot of people over, just serve it with cheese, let people make roll-ups. It is awesome, you'll love it. As always, remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and visit waltonzinc.com and meatgistics.com to find everything but the meat. Thanks for watching, I'm John with Game Bird Gourmet, and we'll see you guys next time.
Subscribe to Walton's YouTube channel to watch more amazing videos, or shop at waltonzinc.com to find everything but the meat. Watch our latest sales and giveaway video by clicking here, or watch another hand-picked video by clicking here.